What is an equation? An equation is a mathematical statement that two expressions are equal. For example, 2 plus 5, that's one expression, equals 7. 7 is another expression. Those two expressions are equal. 2 plus 5 equals 7. And that statement, 2 plus 5 equals 7, is called an equation. Note that an equation contains an equal sign. An expression, like 2 plus 5, there is no equal sign in this expression. There's no equal sign in the expression 7. But in this equation, 2 plus 5 equals 7, there is an equal sign. An equation contains an equal sign. An expression does not contain an equal sign. You solve an equation, but expressions are simplified. X plus 5 equals 7, this is an example of an equation. Notice the equal sign. X plus 5 plus 7 is an example of an expression. Notice, no equal sign. We will see later in this section that the solution to the equation x plus 5 equals 7 is 2. So we solve an equation, or we say we find the solution of an equation. Now for the expression x plus 5 plus 7, we have already learned to simplify such an expression. So an expression is simplified by combining like terms, and the answer in this case is x plus 12. Is y equals 7 the solution to the equation y minus 3 equals 4? Well, we will take what y is supposedly equal to, 7, and replace it where we see the variable y in the equation. Doing so gives us 7 minus 3 equals 4. That is a true statement. So it is a fact that, yes, y equals 7 is the solution to the equation y minus 3 equals 4. Is c equals negative 9 the solution to the equation c plus 3 equals negative 7? We will take what c is supposedly equal to, negative 9, and put that where we see the variable c in the equation. Doing so gives us negative 9 plus 3 equals negative 7. Negative 9 plus 3 is equal to negative 6. So we have negative 6 equals negative 7. This is false. So the answer to the question is C equals negative 9, the solution to the equation C plus 3 equals negative 7. The answer is no. The addition property of equality states, in words, adding the same expression to both sides of an equation will produce an equivalent equation. For example, if we start with the equation A equals B and then add the same expression to both sides, we add C to the left side and we add C to the right side, we produce an equivalent equation. The inverse property of addition states the sum of a number and its opposite is zero, or the sum of a term and its opposite is zero. For example, 4 plus negative 4 is a case of the sum of a number and its opposite, and the answer is indeed zero. 2x plus negative 2x equals 0. Here we have a case of a term plus its opposite, and the answer is 0. How do we solve an equation? We want to solve h plus 8 equals 2. Here's how we're going to solve it. Since 8 is added to h, we are going to add the opposite of 8 to both sides of the equation. So we have h plus 8 equals 2. That's our original equation. We're going to add the opposite of 8, which is negative 8. And we add that negative 8 to both sides of the equation. Now, 8 plus negative 8 is a case of a number plus its opposite, and that gives us 0. So we have h plus 0 equals 2 plus negative 8 is equal to negative 6. H plus 0 is simply h. So we have h equals negative 6. That is the solution. We're supposed to check the solution. That means we take this negative 6 and put it back into the original equation. Doing so would give us negative 6, where this h is, then plus 8 equals 2. We want to know, is this a true statement? Well, negative 6 plus 8, if you lost $6 but gained $8, you're up 2. You have positive 2. So indeed we have a true statement. Solve negative 8 equals w minus 1, then check the solution. To solve for w, we need to deal with the 1 that is subtracted from it. If we think of this subtraction of 1 like a negative 1, we will add the opposite of negative 1, which is positive 1. So to both sides of the equation, we will add positive 1. Negative 8 plus 1 equals w minus 1 plus 1. You notice how we've added plus 1, the same expression, to both sides of the equation. The reason for doing this is that negative 1 plus 1, a number plus its opposite is 0. That gives us w plus 0, which is simply w. And w has been solved for. Now the answer we find by computing this negative 8 plus 1. Negative 8 means you've lost $8. Plus 1 means you've gained 1 back. So you're just down 7. We indicate that with negative 7. So our solution is w equals negative 7. And we're supposed to check. So in order to check, we will take what we think our solution is, negative 7, and put it back into the equation wherever we see w. So the equation will read negative 8 equals, here we insert negative 7 for w. So we have negative 8 equals negative 7 minus 1. And this is indeed a true statement. If you have negative 7, you take away 1 more, so you're even more negative, you have negative 8. Solve c plus 5.6 equals 9, then check the solution. To solve this equation, we must isolate c. We will do that by adding the opposite of 5.6 to both sides of the equation. C plus 5.6 equals 9, that is our original equation. We're going to add the opposite of 5.6, which is negative 5.6. We add this negative 5.6 to both sides of the equation. 5.6 plus its opposite is 0. So we have C plus 0 equals, we'll figure out what it is in a moment, but C plus 0 is C, so we have solved for C. 9 plus 5.6, that is the same thing as 9 minus 5.6. We can do the work on the side. Rewrite 9 as 9.0. Do a little borrowing. And we get C is equal to 3.4. We're supposed to check. In order to check, we take 3.4, that's what we think the solution is, and we're going to put it right back up in here for C. So we have 3.4, inserting 3.4 for C, plus 5.6 equals 9. We'll check by adding decimals vertically. 3.4, 5.6. 4 plus 6 is 10. Carry the 1. 1 and 3 and 4 plus 5 is 9. Bring down the decimal. And 9.0 is the same thing as 9. So 3.4 is indeed the solution for C. Solve x minus 8/9 equals 1/3. Then check the solution. We will solve this by isolating x. Negative 8/9 is how we can regard this term. We want to add the opposite, so we will add 8/9. Our equation is x minus 8/9 equals 1/3. We will add the opposite of negative 8/9, which is positive 8/9. That's added to both sides of the equation. The effect is negative 8/9 plus 8/9. We are adding opposites. That gives us 0. X plus 0, in other words, x. So we have x equals, we have isolated x. On the right-hand side, we're going to figure out what the solution is. And we have to add 1/3 plus 8/9. Now to add 1/3 plus 8/9, we need a common denominator. And 3 and 9 both divide into 9 without remainder. So the fraction 8/9 is not going to be changed. But the fraction 1/3, we multiply by 3. That gives us the common denominator of 9. Multiplying the numerator by the same amount, 3. We have 1 times 3, which is 3. So 1/3 and 3/9 are equivalent. Now we can add these two fractions because their denominators are equivalent. 3/9 plus 8/9 is 3 plus 8/9, or 11/9. So our solution, x equals 11/9. Let's check. We're going to take 11/9, put it right back in here in place of x. So that will give us 11/9 minus 8/9 equals 1/3. We want to know, is this a true statement? Well, notice that on the left-hand side we have two fractions that are subtracted and they have a common denominator. So we have 11 minus 8 divided by 9. Is that equal to 1/3? Well, we have 3/9 equals 1/3. 3/9 is indeed equal to 1/3. We have a true statement. So it is a fact that x equals 11/9 is the solution.